The US military is to build hypersonic missile defense system to defend Russian and Chinese hypersonic missiles. The Russian Vanguard hypersonic missile test is shining light upon an aggressive US plan to prototype, test and deploy hypersonic weapons on an expedited schedule, to defend against enemy attacks by fast-tracking an ability to launch high-impact, high-speed attacks at Mach 5 times the speed of sound. We would like all the resources we can build into the kill chain to hit any target or hold it at risk with hypersonic weapons, Timothy Ray, Air Force Global Strike Command, said at the Air Force Association in September. Russian President Vladimir Putin is, according to numerous news reports and Russia's own state news operation, calling the test a tremendous success, adding that the weapon is invincible and ready to enter service next year. The actual technological capacity of the new Russian weapon has not, as of yet, been verified by public US reports. Legitimate or not, a Russian weapon traveling at hypersonic speeds, naturally, would better enable offensive missile strikes to destroy targets. A key component of this is the fact that weapons traveling at hypersonic speeds would present serious complications for targets hoping to defend against them. They would have only seconds with which to respond or defend against an approaching or incoming attack. The challenge becomes your ability to defend against hypersonic weapons. They are not easily defendable, Ray told an audience at the AFAC conference. Along these lines, the advent of hypersonic weapons is a key reason why some are questioning the future survivability of large platforms such as aircraft carriers. How are ship-based sensors, radar and layered defenses expected to succeed in detecting, tracking and intercepting or destroying an approaching hypersonic weapon traveling at more than 5 times the speed of sound? Hypersonic weapons will quite likely be engineered as kinetic energy strike weapons, meaning they will not use explosives but rather rely upon sheer speed and the force of impact to destroy targets, developers explain. Scientists explain that speed of sound can vary, depending upon the altitude. At the ground level it is roughly 1,100 feet per second. Accordingly, if a weapon is engineered with 2,000 seconds worth of fuel, it can travel up to 2,000 miles to a target, former Air Force Chief Scientist Gregory Zacharias told in an interview. The service recently awarded a second deal to Lockheed to expedite prototyping of a hypersonic weapon, called the Air Launched Rapid Response Weapon, Air Force News reported. The effort involves two separate trajectories, including the air-launched rapid response weapon and a hypersonic conventional strike weapon. The Air Force has now awarded developmental deals for both systems to Lockheed. The most recent award was cited recently in the services around the Air Force new report, which said that Air Force Secretary Heather Wilson is moving as fast as possible when it comes to hypersonic weapons. Recent thinking from senior Air Force weapons developers had held that U.S. hypersonic weapons might first be deployable only by the early 2030s. A report in Popular Mechanics cites Chinese state media as having announced a successful test of a new Wave Rider hypersonic vehicle. The hypersonic vehicle that detached from the booster rocket flew for 400 seconds. Achieving a maximum speed of Mach 5.5 to 6, 4,200 to 4,600 miles an hour, and reaching an altitude of 100,000 feet, the report says. These kinds of propulsion and weapons technologies are currently informing the exploration of hypersonic drone platforms able to surveil, strike and defend. This hypersonic weapons acceleration is taking place within a high-threat global environment. Alongside Russia, China has also been visibly conducting hypersonic weapons tests, leading some to raise the question as to whether the US could be behind key rivals in this area. Senior Air Force weapons developers have explained the rationale in terms of not waiting many more years for a 100% solution if a highly impactful 90% solution can be available much sooner. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.